At this point in our lives, should we be pursuing the short game or the long game? Should we be pursuing today's best opportunities or today's opportunities that provide the most promising tomorrow? Hi, my name is Francisco Gomez. I'm a senior majoring in finance with a thematic sequence in the literature and culture of Spain. Majoring in finance at Miami University really opened my eyes to what all I can do with a finance degree. What can I do beyond banking, corporate finance, auditing, or consulting? It really brought new horizons, and out of all of those new horizons, I decided I want to pursue a career in venture capital. So there are a lot of points that brought me to the ultimate decision of I want to pursue a career in venture capital. And out of all of those points, I want to just touch on my personal and professional growth at Miami University. And now that I'm at a decision point, where do I go now? How do I make sure that the career path that I'm choosing today sets me up for the best tomorrow? So I want to go ahead and start talking about my experiences at Miami. I feel that farmer school business students have a thoroughly unique academic experience. By having ISA departments, marketing departments, entrepreneurship departments, we get to take classes that teach us Excel, that teach us SQL, that teach us, introduction to marketing or new ventures or financial modeling. And it really provides us with such a broad academic base and such functional knowledge that it really starts to set us apart. Lawrence Bradford writes for Forbes magazine, and he wrote an article titled "Why One College Makes First-Year Students Take a Coding Course." And it's about Miami University and how first-year business students have to learn SQL and how they take Excel and how they learn Access. And it really highlights that a lot of industry executives, the main one highlighted is a General Electric executive, really feel that this unique academic experience of learning SQL, of learning Excel, really gives Miami students a step up on the competition. So, in my personal experience, Miami provides great academic opportunities, but also unknowingly provides opportunities through connections. The last internship opportunity that I got was in venture capital. And I received the interview because the interviewee had taught an analyst course at Miami University, and he was thoroughly impressed by the Farmer School of Business and by the students, and just by the career orientation that Miami allows for students to have. So he granted me the interview, and I was fortunate enough to get the internship. But now that I've experienced a lot of personal and professional and academic growth through my years at Miami, I'm at a point where I have to decide where to start my career path. And I find myself wondering, where do I go from here? How do I make sure that I keep growing personally and professionally and academically once I go into the professional world? So I have a decision to make. Do I initially pursue a career in venture capital? Or do I pursue a career in banking or consulting, which could lay a different foundation for perhaps venture capital success later on in my career? So, to try to figure out what leads to success in venture capital, I came across an article from a former colleague of mine. His name is Issa Weaver, and he wrote an article for JobWell titled "Seven Tips for Breaking into Venture Capital Without Connections." And one of the tips is, in essence, be yourself. He highlights that people break into venture capital from startups, from engineering or sales or banking. And it's really all about what you do with your previous experiences once you break into venture capital. So it kind of left me at ease moving forward to make my decision that I can start my career path not in my dream job. And it may just lay a more effective base to have my dream career. So all of these experiences at Miami have really brought me to this decision point where I have to begin my professional career And Miami has allowed me to broaden my horizons, to have choices, and to decide, do I pursue venture capital right now, or do I pursue venture capital in the future? But the one thing that my experiences at Miami have taught me is that patience is a virtue. So what have your experiences at Miami taught you?